YouTube, what it do? It's your boy, Cousin Scoop, and I'm back again with another episode of Mad City Sports. Thank y'all for tuning back in. Yo, first things first, we're going to dive into this week two come from behind like OJ Simpson-style victory we just had against the Denver Broncos, man. Loving it. So I'm going to give you my thoughts and opinion, offensive and defensive grades, and also other bullshit that's been going on around the way. So go ahead and like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and tap in with your boy on IG and Facebook, man. Because I'm always locked in. Keep y'all tuned in and let y'all know what's going on around the way. So, yeah, this is another episode of Mad City Sports. Y'all already know what it do. So let's get it. Do you like that? I most definitely like that, what I saw out there last Sunday, man. I'm trying to tell y'all, man, this offense is off to the races, man, ran by Sam Howell. Putting up 35 points against the Denver Broncos, man. I couldn't ask for nothing more from this coming from behind victory, because real live, man. If you're not hip, Sam Howell was doing his thing, man. Two touchdowns, no interceptions, and damn near 300 yards out there passing, mo. And if you didn't see the game, Slim, and you ain't see these big boy throws your boy made out here, look at these passes he made out here to Scurry Terry, for real. The 30-yarder, man, TD, and right before halftime with the 45, the, what's called John Bates out there, man, your boy out there slinging that rock. And then, man, that fourth down pass to Logan Thomas. Logan, get well soon, bruh. Thank you for holding on to that rock. But I ain't gonna lie, when I joined Havoc, cuz I was ready to go out there and fight my damn self. I was like, fuck this game, son. This for Logan right here. Let's wreck these bombers. But hey, you see your man Nick Gates out there stepping up, like, man, get the fuck out of my man face, all that. So that's what's up, man. We had our teammates back. So the grade on this game, man, I'm gonna have to give it our offense an A minus, man. Giving up four sacks, man, that wasn't good. Also, man, Sam Howell be holding on that ball for too long sometimes. But hey, he was out here doing his thing, willing and dealing, man. Big ups to Eric the Enemy, man. Scoring 35, and DC is like, damn, man, scoring 50, mo. Real loud. We ain't put up 35 points in so long, cuz. So big ups to Eric the Enemy. And what's up with that Chiefs offense out there? I know they messing with him. So, hey, let's go ahead and talk about this defense. So let's go ahead and talk about this defense we seen this past weekend. Bama's playing like straight booty juice out there, man. First quarter, terrible, Slim. They was just letting Russ out that joint cook, mo. And halfway through the second quarter, too, put up 21 points on us like that joint wasn't enough. And Mims, that wide receiver, I don't know if that was cuz from, you know what I'm saying, the Jets or whatever, but he was out that joint frying. I'm trying to tell you, couldn't catch him. He was out there cooking, mo, catching the deep ball. The homo pole, you already know. Hey, that pump return cuz then, mo, he was out there looking electric, man, for real. But hey, honestly, I get this chicken wings, three-piece wing, fries, mumble sauce, all the wrong paint for real. Big boy said, get on my back and let it rise, son. Oh, for real, nah. But Deron put the defense on his back and said, man, let's get him out, man. Let's get him out here. So second half, defense really turned up, man. Three in and outs constantly. Deron Payne putting pressure. And guess who came off to the party? Chase Young and Montez Sweat showed up and said, let's eat two. They was hungry too out there with Deron Payne. So that was looking so wonderful, having four first round picks out there doing their thing, man. Causing havoc out there on Russell Wilson, and man. Hey, and our thing, man. So, hey, Deron going berserk out there will change the game and change the fortune of this team, man, for real. And also, shout outs to Emmanuel Forbes for getting his first interception on the season, man. Big ups to you, young buck. Keep balling and keep grinding, man. So, yeah, so grades I'm giving out for this, you know what I'm saying? Team defense we just had, I give it a B, man. It was going to be close to a B until that Hail Mary happened. I don't know what the hell, man. Bat the ball down, man. That's all y'all got to do is just bat the ball down. Y'all tipping the ball trying to catch picks at the end. But hey, B minus on this defense, man. But they did have seven sacks, looking wonderful. I like that, man. and I expect more out of y'all. So, hey, let's get these grades up. So, let's talk about the rest of this bullshit that's been going on around the way. If you ain't hip, man, let's tune in what happened last week, man. So, week one, hey, they had a whole altercation out there in the stands, man. And the man actually made a news report. The one that actually had the rating. Ray Lewis made a news report. So, hey, go ahead and check this out. Let me know what y'all think about this.
The man seen on a viral video being punched in the face during yesterday's Commanders Cardinals game, speaking to our Shamari Stone. He's in Alexandria with that interview.
Good evening. Right now, Martino Ancora is here at Inova Alexandria Hospital, suffering from injuries he says he received during that brawl. Now, he has cuts on his arms, on his hands, and stitches on his face by his beard. Now, he says that he is actually the victim in this case and not the suspect, but Prince George's County Police disagree. In fact, they arrested and charged him with trespassing, disorderly conduct, and second-degree assault for what happened after the video was shot, they said. They say that what you saw in the video is not related to his arrest. He says these other charges stem from what happened with his interaction with police after the video stopped recording. I want to warn you, this video is disturbing and violent. Let's roll it. The viral video showing 33-year-old Martino Ancora in a black Ravens jersey getting punched 6 times in the head. A guy appears to be holding Ancora's arms back as the man wearing a poncho over a Commander's jersey repeatedly hit Ancora in the face. You can see a security guard in the yellow shirt standing right there while this is all going on. After being hit, Ancora appears to stumble up the stadium stairs. You're now going to hear from him first on Fox 5. What led up to you being punched 6 times?
Shamari, I was there at the game with my girlfriend, just being a spectator. She's a fan of the Commanders. I was just there supporting her on opening day. I was cheering for the Commanders. As I'm in the row, there's a guy a row ahead of me. He started being disrespectful with his words, and as you can see on the video, he pushed me first, and as he pushed me, I tried to lean in, and I was going to push him back, but before I could push him back, the guy in our row actually bum-rushed the whole aisle and knocked us all onto the ground.
Why did police arrest and charge you and not the people who are shown hitting you?
I have no idea.
That shit crazy, right? I know. Thank y'all for tuning in to another episode of Mad City Sports. You already know this your boy Cousin Scoob. Tell me y'all thoughts and opinion. Tap in with your boy, IG, Facebook. Always giving y'all the new, fresh news stories and always sports bet and picks too, man. Get y'all some money. So yeah, I'll let your boy. I ain't got really too much else left to say. Peace. Never mind what I got, nigga, don't watch that, cause I came up, that's all me.